ओम अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपा कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतापदकमलम् श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखावितांश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिन् इति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधो जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुवैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमा प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्या नाम्ने गौरतुषे नमः। नीलाचल निवासाय नित्याय परमात्मने बलभद्र सुभद्राभ्याम् जगन्नाथाय ते नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण। सो थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर अलाउइंग मी टू स्पीक बिफोर ऑल ऑफ यू। So today we are taking a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto. So this verse is before all of you. So I've been asked to share some importance of chanting, some importance of becoming more involved in Krishna consciousness. So this verse is very significant. So how it is significant, I'm going to share it with all of you now. So this verse, this 10th chapter of Srimad Bhagavatam, first of all, how many of you know about something about Srimad Bhagavatam? Have you heard this word, Srimad Bhagavatam? What is Srimad Bhagavatam? One of the Puranas, yeah, and the best Purana, yes, very good. What is Srimad Bhagavatam? Purana written by Vyasadeva. Okay.
It's the glorification of Krishna.
It's the glorification of Krishna. Yes, wonderful. What is Srimad Bhagavatam? You all are studying in CET? All of you? What is Srimad Bhagavatam?
It is dedicated to Krishna.
Dedicated to Krishna, okay. So, so there are two types of Krishna Katha. One is spoken by Krishna and another is spoken for Krishna. So Bhagavad Gita is spoken by Krishna. Bhagavad Gita. And Srimad Bhagavatam is spoken about Krishna. So Bhagavad Gita is spoken by Krishna and Srimad Bhagavatam. So this Bhagavad Gita is the instructions given by Krishna. And where Krishna was giving this instruction? To Arjun on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So that is recorded as Bhagavad Gita. And where we found this Bhagavad Gita? So we found this Bhagavad Gita in the great epic called Mahabharata. So within this Mahabharata there is a Parva, Bhishma Parva. And within that Bhishma Parva we find this. Bhishma Parva means when there are different Parvas. Bhishma Parva means when Bhishma was the commander-in-chief. So for the longest period of time, Bhishma was the commander-in-chief. Hare Krishna. I've watched it. चल तो रहा है लेकिन एक बार चेक करिए कि नहीं वो तो आ रहा है फेसबुक चेक करिए कि ऑडियो आ रही है कि नहीं आ रही है मैं इन क्लास कर रहा था तो वो ऑडियो चली गई उसके बाद नेट बंद होने के बाद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्णा क्लियर है सो एक्चुअली मैं अभी लाइव रिकॉर्डिंग बंद कर दूंगा मैं एक मोबाइल ले रहे हैं रिकॉर्डिंग के लिए अभी रिकॉर्डिंग करेंगे लाइव में बहुत कर नेट दो ये करो करो एक बार रिकॉर्ड करके रखेंगे बाद में अपलोड करना दैट सीम्स इजी सो So when Dronacharya, when Bhishma was the commander in chief, so that particular parva is known as Bhishma Parva. And so within that Bhishma Parva, we find this document called Bhagavad Gita. So how many shlokas are there in Bhagavad Gita? 700 shlokas. So, and how many chapters? 18 chapters. And Srimad Bhagavatam was spoken by son of Vyasadev, his name is Shukdev Goswami. Kya naam hai? Shukdev Goswami. And to whom he is speaking? Shukdev Goswami is speaking this Srimad Bhagavatam to whom? Parikshit. Huh? And other sages were sitting there, but who was the main listener on whose request that Srimad Bhagavatam was revealed is Parikshit. Who is Parikshit? Son of Abhimanyu. And who is Abhimanyu? Son of Arjuna. And who is Arjuna? Son of Pandu. Who is the son of Harry Potter? Who is father of Harry Potter? And who is father of James? James Potter. And who is father?
James Potter's father.
You don't know? Why you don't know? You don't know because he doesn't exist. You don't know because he doesn't exist. That means that is the fiction. Fiction means? That is a fiction. Fiction means?
Manage.
imaginative story. But can you tell that these stories in Mahabharata or Ramayana or stories in Bhagavatam, are they imaginative stories? Are they mythology? Myth? No myth. Why? Because we have the genealogy, lineage. Parikshit's father is Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu's father is Arjun. Arjun's father is Pandu. Pandu's father. And then Parikshit's son is Janmeje, and then his son. So we have the entire genealogy available. That means they were not fictitious characters. समझ आ रहा है क्या समझ आ रहा है कोई पूछेगा if somebody will ask you this question, how I can understand whether it is a fiction or not? So there is a website called, there is a YouTube channel called Anichakra. Have you seen that Anichakra? ओपन करिए, कोई खोलिए अनिचक्र, मैं दिखाता हूँ, लो मुझे दो, नेट खोल के दो. जस्ट डालिए आप लॉर्ड कृष्णा और जीनोलॉजी, जीनोलॉजी, ठीक है. तो ये आप वीडियोस में डालेंगे तो ये आ जाएगा. सब जगह क्या कहते हैं वो लगा के रखा है, हैं, व्हाट्सएप पे, मोबाइल में, यूट्यूब में भी, ताकि पता ना चल जाए कि प्रभु जी हम क्या करते हैं. ये देख रहे हैं इसमें कहां से शुरू हो रहा है, यहां देखिए. जिनोलॉजी ऑफ कृष्णा, ठीक है, कैसे आ रहा देखिएगा. स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम कहां से शुरू हो रहा है देख पा रहे हैं, इधर आ जाओ. बहुत लंबा है, जस्ट बताना क्या चाह रहे, समझ रहे हो. चलता जाएगा. उर्वशी है क्या, हाँ चले गई. चलती जाएगी आगे 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 आगे. क्या नाम आया उसके बाद सूरसेन, उसके बाद वसुदेव, उसके बाद उसके आगे भी चलेगी गाड़ी, कृष्ण के बाद प्रद्युम्न, उसके बाद वज्रनाभ, चलती रहेगी गाड़ी. हैं क्वेश्चन वाला और है, मतलब इतना ऑल दीज नेम्स आर रिकॉर्डेड इन श्रीमद् भागवतम, ये नाम रिकॉर्ड किए गए हैं, उसके बाद भी हैं, उनका अस्तित्व है. तो ये अपने आप और ये कई मतलब हजारों सालों की जनरेशन बता दी गई है. तो इससे क्या प्रमाणित होता है, इट्स नॉट अ फिक्शन. पहली बात तो ये समझ आती है कि tales in Mahabharata are not fiction. Similarly, you'll find genealogy of Pandavas, genealogy of Lord Ramachandra. So they have documented very nicely in this YouTube channel. म्यूजिक पीछे बज रहा था राजा महाराजा टाइप का नहीं बज रहा है सो दैट शोज दैट इफ समबडी इज आस्किंग यू वेदर दीज स्टोरीज दीज आर फिक्शियस स्टोरीज और फैक्ट्स सो हाउ यू कैन प्रूव देम सिंपली बाय शोइंग दैट जीनोलॉजी अगर वो है ना हैरी पॉटर एग्जिस्ट नहीं कर रहा इसका प्रमाण ये कि उसके बाप का नाम हमको पता नहीं दादा का नाम नहीं पता वी डोंट नो हिज जीनोलॉजी है ना So, Srimad Bhagavatam was spoken by son of Vyasadev to King Parikshit. And who is Parikshit? He is the grandson of Arjun, son of Abhimanyu. So, the Srimad Bhagavatam contains 12 cantos and around 18,000 shlokas. And particularly this 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam deals with the pastimes of Lord Krishna. And the shloka that we are taking today is from the 60th chapter. The title of this chapter is Lord Krishna teases Rukmini. Teases. Who is Rukmini? Wife of Krishna, queen of Krishna. So one day Krishna thought that let me tease Rukmini. Because this is the pleasurable moment when the husband teases his wife. So what Krishna is speaking to Rukmini, so he's saying that Rukmini, you are so qualified, so beautiful, you are so beautiful, you are so qualified, and you are coming from the very royal family, but then why you married me? There were alternative options available, and there were kings more powerful than me. There were people those who were more respectful in the society. I am coming from a background. I am a Yadava. In the childhood, I used to steal different items from different homes. So why you married a thief? And I am not a king. Ugrasen is a king. I am just a servant. So if you'll marry some king, you'll become queen. But if you'll marry some servant, then you'll become maid servant. So what is your future? Very, very difficult future. So then Krishna said, you should reconsider. So we can propose this remarriage. If you have married me, so no problem. I'll hand over you to your new husband, and whatever dowry I have taken from your father, so with some interest, compound interest, I'll give it to that person. So this is how Krishna was teasing Rukmini. So this chapter, Lord Krishna teases Rukmini, is one of the favorite chapter of Lord Shiva. So there is a temple in South India. The temple is Guru Vayurappam, have you heard? It's in Kerala. I have recently been there. So there was a devotee of Guru Vayurappam. Guru Vayurappam means, Appam is the Lord. And Guru Vayur, Guru means Brihaspati and Vayu means Vayudev, Pavandev. So Brihaspati and Pavandev, they established one deity, installed one deity in Kerala. So the temple became Guru Vayurappam, the Lord of Brihaspati and Vayu. So it's the Lord Vishnu's temple, Guru Vayurappam. It's very beautiful. In Kerala, you'll find. I was thinking that churches have a certain design, huts and all. Have you seen different churches? And you must have seen in movies also. So churches have this design, huts, and temples have a peculiar design. But in Kerala, temples have that design, like huts. So I was thinking that so this design is originating from Hindu temples only. In Kerala, you'll find all the temples. Like there is a famous temple, Sabarimala temple. You heard? Some Sabarimala case came up. Huh? Yeah, the women were not allowed to enter into Sabarimala. The reason being?
He was Brahmachari.
Sabarimala is Brahmachari. Who is Sabarimala? Kartike?
No.
Sabarimala is considered to be the son of Lord Shiva and Mohini Murti Avatar. In South India, that is. In North India, we don't have that concept of Sabarimala. But in South India, considered who is Sabarimala? They call him. There's another name as well. It's not Kartike. It's the son of
Shiva
and the Mohini Murti form of the Lord. When Lord Vishnu assumed the Mohini Murti form, so then they consider that from them they begot a child called. He became. His name is, क्या बोलते हैं उनको, it's very famous, मैं नाम भूल रहा हूँ, अयप्पा, अयप्पा, सबरीमाला, अयप्पा, so it's very famous in Kerala, in fact somewhere in Maharashtra also they are very famous, but we don't have this concept of अयप्पा in North India. Anyway, so in Kerala you'll find all the temples also having that sort of design. Hut, thatched huts, very beautiful. So this Guruvayurappam is the Lord Vishnu deity, and it was established by Guru and Vayu, Brihaspati and Vayudev. So there was a devotee called Punthanam. Punthanam, it's a Malayali name. Punthanam. Punthanam was a devotee of Guru Vayurappam. So there is a, also close by, there is a around 100-120 kilometers, there is a Shiva temple which opens only for say few 7-8 days in the entire year. So this Punthanam, who was a devotee of Guru Vayurappam, used to recite Srimad Bhagavatam in the Shiva temple when it opened for 7 days darshan. So Punthanam used to carry his Srimad Bhagavatam copy, and then he went to that Lord Shiva temple. I do not remember that name of Lord Shiva temple, but it's very famous. So then he used to sit there and he used to open his Srimad Bhagavatam and he used to recite this Srimad Bhagavatam before the deity of Lord Shiva. So he was narrating this 10th canto, 60th chapter. In front of Lord Shiva. So, and he read few verses first day and then kept the bookmark. You know bookmark? What is bookmark? There are two types of bookmark. One is you put something, the other is dog ears. So intelligent way is to put something, not to make dog ears on. Have you seen dog ears?
Yeah.
People make dog ears. It's not considered to be very good. Punthanam kept his bookmark and kept the Srimad Bhagavatam there itself because he knew that tomorrow I'll come again and I'll continue. So he read this 10th canto, 60th chapter before Lord Shiva. So he completed this chapter. Next day when he came, he saw the bookmark is still. He has completed 60th chapter, but the bookmark is still on the front side. 60 श्लोक खत्म, मतलब 60वां अध्याय खत्म हो गया तो बुकमार्क अध्याय के बाद लगना चाहिए, लेकिन जब आके देख रहे तो वो अध्याय के पहले लगा हुआ, इट्स स्टिल ऑन द फ्रंट साइड. एनीवे ही अगेन स्टार्टेड टू रिसाइट दैट चैप्टर. देन नेक्स्ट व्हेन ही इज कमिंग, सेम थिंग, फिर वो बुकमार्क पहले ऊपर लगा हुआ है, अगेन ही रिसाइटेड 60th चैप्टर. देन नेक्स्ट डे ही केम, अगेन सेम थिंग. So anyway, he could not understand what's happening. But anyway, he was reciting Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, 60th chapter. So on the 8th day, when temple was about to close, so Punthanam offered his obeisances to Lord Shiva. And then he went out. But he, in due course of his movement, he realized that he has forgotten his Srimad Bhagavatam inside the temple. And the temple is now locked. So he came back. Now he wanted to get his Srimad Bhagavatam back, so he was finding some means and ways that all the door is closed, but then how can I get my Srimad Bhagavatam back? So then he was trying to see something from the window. And what he saw? Lord Shiva is sitting there with Parvati on his side, and then they are reading from Punthanam Srimad Bhagavatam. And which chapter Lord Shiva is reading? 10th canto, 60th chapter. And Lord Shiva is narrating that pastime, this 60th chapter, to Parvati. And Punthana was seeing from behind. And then after reciting the complete chapter, Lord Shiva asked, "So Parvati, did you like my narration?" So she said, "Yes, I liked your narration, but not as much as I liked Punthanam's narration." And just by hearing these words of Parvati, Punthanam was in ecstasy, and he started to, like, tears started flowing from his eyes, and Lord Shiva and Parvati disappeared from the sight. So you can well imagine why this chapter is very dear to Lord Shiva. Any guesses?
Because it's more here to Parvati likes.
Parvati likes, yes. So why Parvati and Lord Shiva like this chapter particularly? Very simple answer.
Krishna pleasure.
Krishna ke baare mein pura Bhagavatam hai. Entire Bhagavatam is for Krishna. Why particularly this chapter?
Krishna ka pleasurable moment.
With his wife. Krishna is enjoying with his wife. And Lord Shiva and Parvati are husband wife. So now, for them, what is the best chapter? This is the best chapter. Is it not? So Krishna is enjoying his pleasurable moments with his wife. He is teasing his wife. So Lord Shiva is relishing particularly this chapter. So particularly this chapter is very dear to Lord Shiva. Because Lord Shiva is also a congregation member. He is a grihastha. So he can understand all the intricacies of this chapter. Sometimes Lord Shiva also tries to tease Parvati, so he can get some clue from Srimad Bhagavatam. So Srimad Bhagavatam gives all sorts of clues. If you are coming from a scientific background and you want to know science, Srimad Bhagavatam is the best source. You want cosmology, astronomy, so that Srimad Bhagavatam you'll get. If you want to propose someone, so we have beautiful verses in Srimad Bhagavatam. You can learn those verses and you can go and propose. Your proposal will be accepted, damn sure. 5th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st chapter, there is a king named Agnidhar. And Agnidhar, how is Agnidhar is he's approaching Purvachitti and he's proposing her. So we'll read that verses, very beautiful Sanskrit verses. So you'll get to learn how to propose someone. So Srimad Bhagavatam gives all sorts of information. So, this particular shloka that we have taken now is spoken by Rukmini. So, Lord Krishna told Rukmini that, Rukmini, see, your father wanted you to get married to someone else. But then because you were so obstinate and you wrote a love letter to me. And then I came and I practically kidnapped you. And I snatched you away from other kings and I married you. But do you think it was a far-sighted decision? Do you think it was a mature decision? Krishna is saying. So who wrote the first love letter in the entire creation? Rukmini. So Rukmini wrote a love letter. How she wrote a love letter? So when Rukmini was in the age of getting married, so at that time his father, he was looking for different options naturally. So then, there was one matrimonial facility available and it was Narad Muni. So Narad Muni came and he told Rukmini's father, "See, you're looking for a groom for your daughter. And I must tell you that on this entire creation, there is one person most handsome and his attributes are most sublime. He's most charming. Sweetest of sweet, Madhuram, Adharam Madhuram, Vadanam Madhuram, Nayanam Madhuram, Hasitam Madhuram, मधुराधिपतिर अखिलम मधुरम, ईच एंड एवरी एट्रीब्यूट्स आर स्वीट एंड ही स्टार्टेड देन नारद मुनि स्टार्टेड टू डिस्क्राइब हिज ग्लोरीज हिज पास्ट टाइम्स हिज चार्मिंग ब्यूटी हिज स्ट्रेंथ हिज ऑपुलेंस एवरीथिंग सो एंड हु वाज हियरिंग Rukmini's father was hearing, but Rukmini was also hearing. She was a little shy to come in front, but from another room she was simply hearing about the glories of Lord Krishna. And then what happened? Simply by hearing the glories of Lord Krishna, hum dil de chuke sanam, and she gave her heart to Krishna. So what is the easiest way if you want to give your heart to Krishna? What Rukmini did? Just hear. If you can give your ears to Krishna, then you can give heart to Krishna. If you can give your ears to Krishna, then you can give your heart to Krishna. So whenever some devotees come and tell you something about Krishna, make sure that you receive it very graciously. Because if you can simply give your ears to Krishna, then you can easily sold your heart to Krishna. भगवान कृष्ण की कथा हमारे कानों से अंदर जाती है तो कोई लॉस नहीं होता है ना. एक डकैत था, डकैत. उसके पिताजी ने कहा था कि कुछ भी करना जीवन में, लेकिन ये इस्कॉन वालों से बैठकर हरे कृष्ण वालों से कथा मत सुनना. जीवन में कुछ भी करना, लेकिन हरे कृष्ण वालों की कथा मत सुनना. ठीक है. तो एक बार ये डकैत गया अपने ग्रुप के साथ में, झुंड के साथ में, और राजा के घर में चोरी किया. चोरी करा तो राजा के सिपाही इसके पीछे पड़ गए. तो दौड़ करके जा रहा था तो कहाँ जाए कहाँ जाए, तो बचने के लिए सिपाही पीछे पड़े. तो ये किसकोन मंदिर में घुस गया और जा करके कथा में बैठ गया, क्योंकि ऑप्शन नहीं था, क्या करते है? छुपने के लिए जाके बैठ गया. जाके बैठ गया तो पिताजी की बात याद आई. क्या कहा था पिताजी ने? है ना, हरे कृष्ण वाले कथा सुनाए, कथा में मत जाना. और बोला अगर कभी गलती से फंस जाओ तो सुनना मत, कान बंद कर लेना. कितना और लगेगा ना. मान लीजिए प्रभुदत्त है ना, तुम्हारा नाम क्या है? प्रभुदत्त. आप है, आपका नाम क्या है? बैलोचन. मानो बैलोचन कथा में बैठ गया. बैलोचन के पिताजी ने मानो माना किया, वही जाना है इस्कॉन वालों की कथा, इस्कॉन के बेस में रह, लेकिन कथा मत सुनना. अब कथा में लेकिन जबरदस्ती बैठना पड़ता, नियम है. अब ऐसे करके बैठेगा तो कितना और लगेगा. तो क्या करता वैसे, उसी तरीके से वो जो डकैत था वो कथा में बैठ गया. अब लेकिन ऐसे कैसे कैसे बैठेगा है ना. तो कोई ऑप्शन नहीं था, कथा तो सुननी पड़ेगी. तो कथा कान के अंदर जाने ही लग गई, क्या करते. तो उस दिन क्या चैप्टर चल रहा था, तो उस दिन प्रभु जी कथा सुना रहे थे. क्या कथा सुना रहे थे? बता रहे थे कि श्रीमद् भागवतम के 5th कैंटो में, 5वें स्कंद में, ये देख रहे हैं आप सृष्टि लीला, भगवान के पूरे ब्रह्मांड की सृष्टि का वर्णन है. तो उस यूनिवर्स के अंदर, विद इन दैट यूनिवर्स, जो आप गोल देख रहे हैं वो एक सिंगल यूनिवर्स है. तो उस एक यूनिवर्स के अंदर बहुत सारे प्लैनेट्स हैं. दैट डे दैट सेंट वॉज रिसाइटिंग, दैट प्रभु जी वॉज रिसाइट वॉज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट ऑन दिस डिफरेंट प्लैनेट्स वॉट सॉर्ट्स ऑफ लिविंग एंटिटीज आर स्टेइंग. उनके क्या एट्रीब्यूट्स होते हैं, वो कैसे दिखते हैं, कैसे क्या खाते हैं, कैसे चलते हैं, उनके क्या एट्रीब्यूट्स होते हैं, क्या करते हैं, एटसेट्रा. तो वो बता रहे थे, ही वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग अबाउट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ डेमीगॉड्स, देवताओं के कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स बता रहे थे. तो उन्होंने बताया, तीन चीजें बताई कि देवता लोग जब धरती पे आते हैं कभी धरती पे पैर नहीं रखते. जब देवता लोग धरती पे आते हैं धरती पे पैर नहीं रखते. उन लोग को धरती है ना, बोलते कलयुग चल रहा है और धरती के लोग ऐसे तुच्छ हैं है ना, तो धरती अपवित्र हो गई, हम धरती पैर नहीं रखेंगे. तो वो हमेशा वैसे लटकते रहते हो हवा में, कोई पैर नीचे नहीं रखते. फिर उसके बाद में है फिर दूसरी बात सुनाई कि भाई देवता लोग जो माला पहनते हैं वो हमेशा खिली रहती, कभी मुरझाती नहीं है. ठीक है. और तीसरी बताई कि देवता लोग जो जो भी उनका ड्रिंक पीते होंगे, क्या बुल, क्या रेड बुल वगैरह है ना, है उनका जो भी वो रस पीते होंगे तो वो बहुत अच्छी खुशबू देता है. तो वो डकैत ने सुना, बात तो अच्छी बता दी, ऐसा क्या मतलब देवताओं के बारे में पता चले. एनीवे, लेकिन कौन सी ये कथा जो सुनी है कब काम आ जाए इसको पता नहीं। तो उस दिन क्या हुआ, रात के लोग पार्टी करने के लिए गए, यहाँ से छूट करके गए, तो पार्टी करके भी डकैत लोग डकैती डाले हैं, सफल हुए हैं, उसके बाद क्या होगा है ना, पार्टी करेंगे, बोटलें खोलेंगे, बकरे कटेंगे, तब तो मजा आएगा है कि नहीं। कॉलेज में पार्टी कैसे होती है, ऐसी होती है ना, तो बोटलें नहीं खोले और बकरे ना कटे तो फिर पार्टी किसको कहते हैं है? क्या क्या कह रहे हमारे संडे फीस्ट होता है क्या कॉलेज में, तो पार्टी ऐसी होती है। देखो अब उसके लिए अलग स्टोरी सुनानी पड़ेगी, बताई थी कि मैंने, अरे यार एक नाव में है ना, एक नाव चलाने वाला था, स्टोरी नहीं सुना आप लोगों ने, तो नाव चला नाविक था, तो नाविक था और उसमें ऐसे चार आदमी बैठे हुए थे है ना, एक साइंटिस्ट था, एक पॉलिटिशियन था, एक बिजनेसमैन था, सुना है, तो इस तरीके से तो जब नाविक नाव चला रहा था तो साइंटिस्ट बोलता है, पता है दुनिया कितने आगे निकल गई है, 5G आ गया है और इसकी टेक्नोलॉजी आगे बढ़ गई है, ये वो दाए मैं बहुत कुछ बता रहा है, बोले तुम अभी भी नाव चला रहे हो, देखो कि टेक्नोलॉजी कितनी आगे बढ़ गई है। तो बोले मैं तो गरीब आदमी, मुझे तो केवल नाव चलाना आती है। तो साइंटिस्ट कहता है यू आर 25% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड, सुना है। फिर वो बिजनेसमैन बताता है, अच्छा पता ऐसे बिजनेस होता है, ऐसे स्टॉक्स में इन्वेस्ट करते हैं, ऐसा ही होता है, ऐसा होता है, इतना रिटर्न मिलता है इसमें। बोले मैं तो गरीब नाव वाला हूँ, मैं तो डेढ़ी का वेज पाता हूँ, यू आर 50% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड। फिर वो पॉलिटिशियन बताता है, पता है ना ये क्या बिजनेसमैन और साइंटिस्ट कर रहे हैं, हम देखो है ना है, हाँ हम देश चलाते हैं है ना। और बोले पॉलिटिक्स भी बहुत बड़ा बिजनेस है, नहीं है ना, आप इलेक्शन में इन्वेस्ट करो और फिर आपको बाद में रिटर्न मिलेगा, नहीं होता है सर, ऐसा होता है कि नहीं होता है। तो बोले मैं तो गरीब नाव चलाने वाला हूँ, मुझे क्या पता है सब पॉलिटिक्स वॉलिटिक्स कैसे चलती है। बोले यार 75% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड। अब उसके बाद क्या हुआ, बीच समुद्र में जब नाव चली गई नदी में, तो उसके बाद बहुत तेज बारिश होने लगी, तूफान आने लगा, नाव ऐसे ऐसे होने लग गई। अब वो नाविक पूछ रहे तैरना आता है, योर 100% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड। ठीक है अब इस स्टोरी का नेक्स्ट वर्जन सुनो, ठीक है नेक्स्ट वर्जन सुनाओ, इसी स्टोरी का नेक्स्ट वर्जन। ठीक है तो सिगरेट पी कॉलेज में, नहीं पी, यू 25% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड। बॉटले खोली, झूठ मत बोलो, नहीं खोली, यू 50% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड। ओयो ओयो 75% लाइफ इज वेस्टेड, लेकिन हरे कृष्णा नहीं किया 100% कॉलेज लाइफ इज वेस्टेड। ठीक है तो कॉलेज में अगर 25% लाइफ वेस्ट, ठीक है बॉटले नहीं खुली तो 50% लाइफ वेस्ट, और ओयो नहीं गए तो, लेकिन हरे कृष्णा नहीं किया तो 100% कॉलेज लाइफ वेस्टेड। तो डकैत लोग पार्टी किए है ना, तो अब डकैत लोग कहाँ पार्टी करते जनरली, काली माता के मंदिर में, ठीक है ना। तो काली माता के मंदिर में पार्टी हो रही है और खूब चढ़ गई है ना, जब चढ़ गई जम के तो सब झूम बराबर झूम, नाच रहे गा रहे, बढ़िया पार्टी हो रही है। अब ये सब डकैत मिलके देख रहे हैं, आज काली माता भी डांस कर रही है हमारे साथ, आज तक तो ऐसा देखा नहीं, ज्यादा पीली गई, इतनी पीली है कि एक दूसरे को चिमटी कोड़ के कर रहे हैं, जाग रहे कि सो रहे हैं, आज काली माता क्यों डांस कर रही है। काली माता ऐसे उनके खूब सारे हाथ 10-12 हाथ ऐसे ऐसे हो रहे हैं और बढ़िया डांसिंग चल रही है। तो ये जो जो आज क्लास में गया था समहाउ फंस गया था हरे कृष्ण वाले क्लास में, ये पीछे से देख रहा है, पिया तो ये भी हुआ है लेकिन क्लास गया था तो कुछ ना कुछ तो उसको स्मरण रह गया। यार देवता लोग पैर जमीन पे नहीं रखते, काली माता जमीन पे डांस कर रही है, दाल में कुछ काला है, देवता लोग की माला मुरझाती नहीं है, काली माता की तो माला बड़ी मुरझाई हुई है, दाल में कुछ काला है। और बोले देवता लोग ऐसा सोमरस पीते हैं उससे खुशबू आती है, तो हांडिया की हांडिया जानते ना क्या, उड़ीसा की देसी
इतनी गंदी बदबू आ रही है। तो ये क्या है, पीजी साइड से निकल लिया। सुबह न्यूज़पेपर में खबर आई कि सारे डकैतों को राजा के सिपाहियों ने काली माता का रूप धारण करके काट काट के मार डाला। अब ये पिताजी को न्यूज़पेपर दिखा, देखिए पिताजी आप मना किए थे ना ये हरे कृष्ण वालों के पास क्लास सुनने जाने के लिए, देखो आज मेरी जान बच गई जस्ट बिकॉज एक क्लास अटेंड करी थी। तो इसलिए जो भगवानी कथा हम सुनते हैं ना, उसका कभी भी लॉस नहीं है। वो कब बेनिफिट दे जाए, नेहा भी कमो नाशोस्ति पत्वायो ना विद्यते स्व अल्पम अपि अस्य धर्म से त्रायते महतो भयात्। वो कौन सा जीवन वो कब काम आ जाए पता नहीं। अजामिल का नाम सुना है, सुना है अजामिल की स्टोरी सुना है। सो इट इज सेड दैट अजामिल, सो अजामिल वॉज अ गुड पर्सन बट समहाउ बिकॉज ऑफ बैड एसोसिएशन ही टर्न्ड इनटू अ रोग, कंप्लीटली पूरा तरीके से भ्रष्ट हो गया। इतना भ्रष्ट हो गया कि उससे लोग डरते थे, मतलब कोई उसके पास जाना नहीं चाहता था। एंड ही स्टार्टेड कीपिंग प्रोस्टिट्यूट्स एंड ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ नॉनसेंस, ही स्टार्टेड किलिंग पीपल, ही स्टार्टेड रोबिंग देम, सो ही बिकेम कंप्लीटली लाइक पूरा क्रिमिनल हो गया वो। तो एक बार अजामिल के घर पे एक साधु आए थे एंड एट दैट टाइम अजामिल्स वाइफ हु वॉज अ प्रोस्टिट्यूट शी वॉज प्रेग्नेंट एंड अजामिल वॉज नॉट एट होम। तो एंड दैट साधु केम एंड साधु वॉज नॉट अवेयर दैट दिस इज अजामिल्स हाउस एंड अजामिल इज अ वेरी नोटोरियस क्रिमिनल इन दिस एरिया वॉट एवर। सो एट दैट टाइम वेन ही अप्रोच दैट साधु अप्रोच्ड, तो अजामिल की वाइफ कहती है अरे साधु जी आप कहाँ फंस गए, यहाँ गलत जगह आप आ गए। आई वॉज इन कांचीपुरम, यू नो कांचीपुरम इन साउथ इंडिया, जस्ट रिसेंटली वी वर देयर। सो वी वर नॉट गेटिंग एनी अकोमोडेशन, सो समहाउ समवेयर वी टुक ए होटल एंड एज वी लैंडेड इन दैट होटल एंड नहा धोकर के सब रेडी हुए, जैसे मैं बाहर आया एंड समवन हैज सेड स्वामी स्वामी दिस इज बैड प्लेस नॉट गुड नॉट गुड, पुलिस पुलिस एनी टाइम पुलिस नॉट गुड। लेटर वी गॉट टू नो दैट दैट्स इन रेड लाइट एरिया काइंड ऑफ, एनी वे सो जस्ट सी दी हाउ कलयुग हैज एडवांस। कांचीपुरम इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी दक्षिण काशी एंड यू फाइंड दिस कम्युनिस्ट, इट्स तमिलनाडु गवर्नमेंट इज लाइक कम्युनिस्ट गवर्नमेंट, सो दे हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्ट्रॉयड द कल्चर, सो नो स्पिरिचुअल वैल्यू। इनफैक्ट इन दैट कांचीपुरम टेम्पल कॉम्प्लेक्स दे सर्व ओनियन गार्लिक इन द नेम ऑफ प्रसादम, but means knowingly so that they want to break the religion because it is all run by communist, so bad culture. Anyway, so this sadhu, he somehow entered into that place and the wife of Ajamil who was pregnant at that time, and he said Swamiji this is not a right place for you to come, it's a red light area, it's a bad area and you should not come here, you please go from here, if my husband will get to know that you are here, he's a bad criminal. So that sadhu went away, but he said that it's fine, but he could understand that although this is a bad area, people are all criminals, all prostitutes everywhere, how can I benefit them, because that is the nature of a saint, he always considered how can I benefit them. He said okay, I'll do that, I'm going, but you do one favor to me. And the wife said what? The sadhu said since you are pregnant, you name your child as Narayana, that's all. So what sort of piety Ajamil has done? Nothing. Only one benefit, like when Sadhu came and this wife of Ajamil had little soft corner toward the Sadhu. That this is not a good place for you, this is a bad area, kindly go from here. Similarly, I am just giving this example. We were at Kanchipuram, that person who was telling this is not a good place, Swami, you go away. He is doing little service. What that little service can give back to them, they don't know. Yesterday we were hearing that story. There was a king named Nriga. Have you heard? Nriga. It's in Srimad Bhagavatam, story of Nriga. So Nriga, he was a very, very benevolent person. Khub daan deta tha. But then because of some bad thing happened, and in next life he became a lizard. Big lizard, chameleon. big chameleon. And when Krishna was in Dwarka, so his sons, different children of Dwarka, they were playing around and they went near a well and they saw this big chameleon, big lizard. And these children, they were trying to bring that lizard outside, but they could not do so. And it was not coming out. And then the children went to their father, Krishna. Father, please come and see that big lizard is there. And Krishna put the hand and brought that lizard back here. Lizard was actually waiting for Krishna to come. A question arises, this Nigga was very benevolent, very charitable person. But something bad happened because of that bad thing. Bad results came out and he became a lizard. What piety he did that Krishna, he could get the touch of Krishna. ऐसा कौन सा कार्य किया था? दान तो कर रहा था, सब दान से उसको ये बेनिफिट नहीं मिला, सबको दान करने से बेनिफिट नहीं मिला. पर्टिकुलरली जब बहुत सारे लोगों को दान करता था, उसमें से एक साधु उनके घर में आया था जो मंदिर निर्माण कर रहा था. ही वाज कंस्ट्रक्टिंग अ टेंपल एंड रेगा गिव हिम सम डोनेशन एंड द रिजल्ट ऑफ द डोनेशन वॉज ही गॉट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एसोसिएट विद कृष्णा डायरेक्टली. जस्ट सी, सो व्हाट दी स्टोरीज आर टेलिंग, any small touch with Krishna, either small touch with chanting, small touch with sadhu, small touch with Krishna katha, what benefit it will give us, we don't know. So this dacoit, he got little benefit. He just sat for one class, but his life was saved. So little Krishna consciousness can save us from biggest danger. So Rukmini, what she did? The only thing she did was, she heard about Krishna. And just by hearing about Krishna, what happened? He got attracted towards him. And then she wrote a love letter. And she told Krishna, my father is getting married. Like there are so many kings in coming for my Swayambara. But I don't want to get married to them. Kindly you come. On the day, on just day before a marriage, it was already fixed with Shishupal, because all the father wanted her to get married with Krishna, her brother was very much avengeful. So he wanted him to get married to Shishupal. He wanted her to get married to Shishupal. So Rukmini told Krishna, she wrote in the letter, that such and such day of my marriage, just before one day, I'll go to Durga's temple for worshipping there, and you kindly come and kidnap me. You take me away and we'll have a happy life. So it was all induced by Rukmini. So Krishna heard, Krishna saw that new love letter, and then Krishna approached, and just like in movies, Krishna reached that place and took her hand, her love, aise uthaya, Krishna ne rath pe chadaya, aur pura movie dekhe jaise na kya kehte hero upar hai, heroine niche hai, aur is tarike se ek haath mein रथ चलाते हुए कृष्ण और रुक्मिणी को लेकर के जा रहे हैं, जैसे लिखा है श्रीमद् भागवतम में, जैसे सियारों के झुंड में से शेर अपने शिकार को लेकर के चला जाता है, इस तरीके से इतने राजा महाराजाओं के झुंड में से कृष्ण केम एंड ही टुक रुक्मिणी एंड वेंट अवे. सो दिस रोमांस इज, सो वॉट एवर यू नो इमोशंस आर देयर, आइदर इट इज रोमांस और इधर इट इज वेलर, एवरीथिंग इज कमिंग फ्रॉम कृष्ण, और स्वीटनेस और इनोसेंस, all the emotions are actually coming from Krishna. So Krishna took away Rukmini, and this particular incident, after many years, now Krishna is telling Rukmini, Rukmini, see, you know, you heard about me from Narad Muni. We never met actually. Narad Muni actually exaggerated my glories. It's not like that actually. And then you wrote a love letter to me, and because you wrote it to me, then I am a Kshatriya, so then I need to do that. Just like it is a Kshatriya custom that if someone is requesting a Kshatriya to get married, so Kshatriya should give her protection, should get married. Just like Hidimba approached Bhima, and then Bhima was obliged to get married to Hidimba. In Shimla there is a temple of Hidimba. Have you been to Shimla, any one of you? Hidimba temple is there. That particular incident took place where Bhima got married to Hidimba, and their son was Ghatotkach. So it's a Kshatriya custom. It is someone request for marriage, so they cannot deny. It's against their valor. So Krishna said that, you know, you wrote to me and therefore I came and got married to you. So, but you know, you should now reconsider. It was not a good, you know, good decision. You could have better options. So anyway, you can still think about it. And the word that Krishna spoke was, Krishna particularly spoke that, Rukmini, you are not very mature. You haven't seen the world. Dunyadari kuch dekhi nahi tumne. है ना, तुम न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ती नहीं हो, है ना, थिंक स्कूल देख फॉलो करती नहीं हो, तुमको कैसे पता चलेगा कि दुनिया में क्या चल रहा है ना. इसलिए आउट ऑफ सेंटिमेंट एंड इमोशन यू रोट टू मी एंड आई केम एंड आई किडनैप्ड यू प्रैक्टिकली. सो दैट वाज नॉट अ गुड डिसीजन. सो इन रिस्पॉन्स टू दिस कृष्णास व्यू पॉइंट, रुक्मिणी गेव हर आंसर. दैट आंसर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड वॉट रुक्मिणी सेड, Krishna spoke that you are not mature enough to decide for yourself that who is the right person for you. You are not mature. Out of immaturity, out of childish behavior, out of sentiment, you approached me, and what happened? What was happened? And that was not a good decision. Now Rukmini is answering Krishna. No, Krishna, whatever did is the best decision. And what Krishna, what Rukmini is saying, this verse is saying, Yad vanchaya nirpashikhamanyo angavanya jayant nahush gadadha aikapatyam rajyam visijya vivisur vanam ambujaksha sidantite anupadvim ta ihi stha kim. What this verse is actually telling, Rukmini is telling, very important thing she is telling, okay, I might be immature. I took decision out of sentiment. But Krishna, there is a history of so many big kings. To achieve your lotus feet, they have given up their entire kingdom. Rajyam visujya. They have given up their entire kingdom. Rajyam visujya vivisur vanam. And they entered into forest. What Rukmini is saying? Try to understand what Rukmini is saying. My understanding was very immature, maybe, probably. I was sentimental. I was not foresighted. Nobody was there to guide me properly. Fine. But Krishna, tell me, why these big kings, and she is taking some name, why these big kings, those who are not just, कोई ऐसा नहीं कि TCS में जॉब लगाओ 25,000 रुपए तनख्वाह मिलता हो, नहीं, they were the kings of the entire planet. Their sovereignty could not be challenged. Their wealth could not be even counted. They were having, you know, big forces of ministers to guide them. I was immature. Nobody was there to guide me. But these kings, they were having so many ministers. These kings were learned. These kings were full of valor. And they were not just ruling some small tract of land. They were the kings of the entire planet. But just to achieve your lotus feet, just to take shelter of your lotus feet, they gave up their entire kingdom and entered into forest. I might be a sentimentalist, I might be immature, I might be unintelligent, but what about these kings? That means, that shows that my decision was not wrong. In fact, those who are most intelligent, most smart, most, those who are actually, fortunate, they are the one who take shelter of your lotus feet. So this is how Rukmini is actually counteracting, countering the arguments of Krishna. Krishna is saying, by with you'll marry me, you have married me, and your future is very uncertain. You'll get frustrated in life. Rukmini is saying, no, no, no. How can I be frustrated in my life? If these kings, they have thought of everything, they have assessed the whole situation and then decided, no, the best path is to take shelter of your lotus feet. So if they are not fearing future, why should I fear future? If they are not frustrated, why should I be frustrated? Makes sense? So what is the lesson that we are learning today? What is the lesson?
No matter what it is, we have to take shelter.
Why? Why we have to take shelter? Why we have to take shelter? अरे बड़े बड़े लोगों ने इनकी शेल्टर ली है, हम किस खेत की मूली है? हम किस खेत की मूली है? कृष्ण की शेल्टर किसने ली है? आई वॉज स्पीकिंग इन उत्कल यूनिवर्सिटी वंस, सो वन स्टूडेंट आस्क्ड मी दिस क्वेश्चन दैट ही सेड दैट इट इज सेड इन भगवद गीता फोर्थ चैप्टर इमम विवस्वते योगम प्रोक्तावान अहम अव्यम. कृष्ण इज सेइंग टू अर्जुन, अर्जुन आई गिव दिस नॉलेज टू सन गॉड. And then sun god gave this knowledge to Manu. Manu gave this knowledge to Ichchavaku. And it is how it was coming down in Parampara. And then that student asked me that, Prabhuji, why Krishna gave this knowledge to sun god? Very, very honest question. Why to sun god? There are so many demigods. Why just to sun god? So fortunately, our spiritual master, His Holiness Bhaktacharya Maharaj, you have seen his photo outside. Yeah. So... yeah, because he visited here once, so still that welcome, that note is there. So once I was sitting in his class and one devotee asked this question. So fortunately I was there in that class when Maharaj was answering this question, and the same question was asked by the student in Utkal University. Why Krishna spoke this knowledge to sun god? Because sun god and moon god, they are the two main personalities from where the Kshatriyas, Suryavansh and Chandravansh, are coming up. Kshatriya dynasties are coming from either Soma or Surya. And Kshatriya means the ruling class. So this ruling class must be trained in this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Is it not? With that intention, Krishna gave this knowledge to sun god. Sun god gave this knowledge to Manu. Manu gave this knowledge to Ichchavaku. All they were... the ruling class. The ruling class must have this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Yesterday I was reading, Srila Prabhupada was sitting with the niece of Subhash Chandra Bose, Lalita. And Lalita was arranging actually Srila Prabhupada's meeting with Indira Gandhi. So at that time Lalita and Prabhupada was having this conversation, and Prabhupada was telling that how it is important for the rulers of the country to be trained up in this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Because once if they will be trained in this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, the entire country will be peaceful and happy. In fact, Srila Prabhupada wrote certain notes while discussing with Indira Gandhi. But unfortunately, Indira Gandhi was because just 2-3 days back, Bangladeshi Prime Minister was assassinated. So she was not in the right mood. So Prabhupada could not bring up that point. Prabhupada then only requested that kindly allow visas to my disciple, that's all. So Prabhupada, then Indira Gandhi asked Prabhupada that how do you know that they are not CIAs, CIA agents from America, the what we say,